Welcome to This Day in Baseball and our Daily Rewind. My name's Tom Hannon and I'm your host. Today we are bringing you the radio broadcast from the 1934 World Series Game 6 at Detroit, where the Tigers are trying to finish off St. Louis up 3-2. Paul Dean will face Schoolboy Rowe in this classic. I hope you enjoy the game, folks.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen of the radio. This is Ted Hughes speaking from Navin Field, Detroit, where the Detroit Tigers and St. Louis Cardinals are battling for the World Championship. The play-by-play descriptions of all the World Series games are brought to you with the compliments of the Ford Motor Company, Mr. Henry Ford, Mr. Edsel Ford, and your local Ford dealer, producers and distributors of Ford and Lincoln cars and Ford trucks. The sponsors will be amply repaid if you get enjoyment from these broadcasts. In order that you might hear the play-by-play description of this game in its entirety, the Paris Medicine Company has kindly omitted its regular afternoon broadcast. On behalf of the Ford Motor Company and the Columbia Network, it's a pleasure to be sitting here at the ballpark watching everything that goes on before the game. And for that matter, contemplating everything, the pleasure doubles. All last night, as the T-trains rolled over the railroad neighborhood, while ballpark turned in early and pressmen filed stories and swap songs and sayings, the fact that this is a musical World Series soon become more strongly to my mind. On the one side, to the rhythm of the clicking wheels and rails, you could hear that cardinal train grinding out that great old classic, "Stop that tiger, take that tiger," and it seemed to grow louder and louder. On the other side, you could hear that wailing moan of the downhearted fans giving an undercurrent of that great old classic of the 49th State of the Union, "Got the Blues, Got the Blues, Got the St. Louis Blues." And that makes the counter melody and tempo. That this is a series based on musical terminology goes further in the fact that the Tiger fans who rose at dawn to meet the homecoming American Leaguers at the station greeted those ball hustlers with a note of appreciation that whipped through the ship morning air in a grand crescendo. And that's how this morning, as we wended that quite weary way to Navin Field, the sun shining and the weather zippy enough to make your steps light and airy, we sang a song of satisfaction over the World Series of 1934. It's been full of all kinds of baseball and no end of good fun. Unfortunately, the fall classic may end today. The Tigers beat out the 3-2 for the Cards. And the pitcher for the Tigers today will be none other than Master Schoolboy Rowe himself. His is the awesome figure of a colossal Rowe who stands between the Cardinals and a chance at another game tomorrow. But you never can tell. Baseball is and always will be a game entirely dependent upon the support given a pitcher by the men who line up behind him. Now on the other side of the fence will be Paul Daffy Dean, the younger member of the Brothers Dean family, which hurled the Cards to a surprise pennant in the National League this year. And in between them are the possessors of 2 victories and 1 defeat in this present autumnal classic that has now reached the 6th game. Paul trimmed the Tigers in the 3rd game of the series in very workmanlike fashion, and may be able to do so again today if the Cards get what are known as the breaks. Texas was served up to them in that now distinctly and differently removed 1st game of the series, which was played here October the 3rd, when the entire Tiger infield bobbled this and that to give the Cards an 8-3 victory behind big teams. Verging upon their greatest achievement in Major League Baseball, that in being 1 game from the first World Championship ever owned by a Tiger Town baseball man, these self-famed Bengals are on the threshold of immortality today. With the great Schoolboy pinning his plans and issues of the almost demoralized forces of the Redbirds, the local citizenry are hysterically acclaiming Mickey Cochran and all the lads as our next world champion, thus giving the Redbirds no quarter. But Frankie the Fordham Flash Fritz has his own ideas of that too. No believer in odds which are overwhelmingly against him, the playing manager of the visiting team boldly declares that powerhouse hitting will blast the giant Schoolboy off the hilltop and pave way for the triumphant rush of the Redbirds to the 2 victories needed to give him and his red-breasted birds that coveted championship play. The interest is not only with the spectator and the reader as much as it is with those distantly removed from the park. Intent upon every word, excited thousands of sporting telegrams and letters regarding the series to date. The magic of the names of Wallace Beery, Jimmy Dunn, and other screenies, or bandsmen such as Bernie Cummins and Johnny Hamp, or even instant news talks like Jimmy Coughlin, have had an electrifying effect in bringing the world close upon us as the Sydney press boxes can send out the progress of the ball game. Everywhere at every place, the game had attracted listening posts, and the appreciation of a fan, large or small, has been a source of gratification to Pat Flanagan and Frank Walsh, who are cooperating in bringing the ball game to you play by play. There's a pack of information behind the scorecards, and there's observations enough to pass it down to everyone. For that purpose, we should give you Pat Sonnigan, whose insights and sidelights will refresh your memory and bring you up to date on the 1934 World Series. And there you are, Pat.
Okay, Fred. How about you, ladies and gentlemen? During the regular season, a fan always yells, "What's his batting average?" when a ball player is mentioned. The ball player asks, "How does he hit in the clinches?" They want to know if he hits with men on bases or is what they call a lonely hitter. Now, looking at the series so far, we find St. Louis as a team without hitting Detroit, 46 hits to 43, and has a team batting average of 251 compared to the Tigers' 235. St. Louis shows five hitters, four of them regular, hitting well over 300. Detroit has four, three of them regular, hitting above the 300 mark. So what then is the difference that shows Detroit ahead 3-2 on games? Pitching for one thing, errors for another, and hitting when the men are on bases for the third. Now, under that means, we find that the Cardinal pitchers have walked twice as many men as the Tiger swingers, 22-11 to be exact. The Tiger pitchers as a whole have used a better campaign to pace. The fireball is all right at times, but the curve and the slow ball are just as effective. Today's game has two possibilities: a draw for the Cardinals, or a world championship for the Tigers. And your guess is just as good as mine. Now, the pitchers for today show Paul Dean, the boy from Holdenville, Oklahoma. The youngster who bats and throws right-handed, who won his game in the series, and who spends his winters in Houston, Texas. His greatest claim to fame in this year of 1934 was the fact that he pitched a no-hit game. During the season, he campaigned mostly against the Giants and found them very easy, and turned up with 19 to keep and 11 defeats as a first-year man. Linwood Schoolboy Rowe's greatest claim to fame this year is the fact that he won 16-6, but the Philadelphia Athletics spoiled that 17-4. However, he turned up with 24 victories and 8 defeats, and he showed beautiful pitching in the game that he won just a few days ago. Now, ladies and gentlemen, that concludes my part of this program here at the present time, so I'm going to turn the microphone over to Frank Locke, who will tell you what is going on in this ball game, play by play. You'll see the lineup for the average and so on. All right, Frank.
Thanks, Pat. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. And we're all set to go here in just a few moments now in the sixth game of this World Series, which at the present time reached three victories for the Detroit Tigers and two for the Cardinals. And here's the probable starting lineup for this afternoon. If you have your scorecards and pencil ready, we'll call them and give you a chance to dot them down. For Detroit, White, center field. Cochran, catcher. Gehringer, second base. Goslin, left field. Rogel, short. Greenberg, first base. Owen, third. Fox, right. And Roe, pitch. For the Cardinals, Martin, third base. Rothrock, right field. Swish, second base. Medwick, left field. Holland, first base. The steering is going up. They just call off the lineup and announce Rowe as the pitcher. Got a big hand from the Detroit Lancer. Collins will be at first base for the Cardinals. The Lancer is set. And either Horcotti or Fullerton center will get that in just a moment. DeRoche short and Paul Dean will be on the firing line. The Lancer will do the catching. Just call that off. Horcotti center, DeRoche short, and Paul Dean pitch. The umpires will be Clem working at the plate, Geisel at first, Risen at second, and Owen at third. Pauline also got a nice share from the fans, nice hand, because his name was called off as the starting pitcher for St. Louis this afternoon. This is the first time that two winning pitchers are meeting in the series. Rowe is the national anthem. Thank you. is going out on the field now. The umpires have just finished their conference, and the men are taking their respective positions on the playing diamond. The park has again jammed this afternoon, and outside of the park, there's thousands that were unable to get in. They just had to fight their way through the crowd to get into Navin Field this afternoon. The Detroit Tigers are tossing the ball around in the infield now, taking their preliminary warm-up run. Rowe has not come out to the plate as yet. At the margin, there is Rowe now strolling out to the mound. We made the reference coming out to the plate. We met to the mound and listen to the hand that Rowe is getting as he strolled out to the rubber. Mickey Castle will be again be back at the plate working with Rowe. And for the Cardinals, it will be Paul Dean and Delance. Several of the Cardinal pitchers and catchers going down to the bullpen. Apple Martin will be the first man. Carlton, Walter, Mooney, and Davis going down to the bullpen for the Cardinals. And Healy. Apple Martin is the first man up for St. Louis and the first half of the first inning. Pepper is standing just to the right of the plate, looking those pitches over while he's warming up there with Mickey Cochran. Umpire Clem also standing just to the right of the plate. Martin, Rothrock, and Frisch will be the first three men. They go Captain Crow down to Gallagher at second base. Martin has a very nice average in the series there. He hit 381 so far in the five games. Right-handed hitter. They're all set to go. Martin stepping in the batter's box. The right-handed hitter. Crow is on the mound getting a signal from Mickey Cochran. And this sixth game is just about to get underway. Go get the signal. Sanchez wind up to the pitch. There's the first one to Martin. Foul. Back up into the fifth spot. Back of the plate. And the count is one strike on top of Martin. And umpire Clem tosses out of the ball to Rowe. Rowe is standing back off the mound. Rubbing the cloth off. He's coming back in on the rubber. Getting a signal again from Dustin. One strike is the count. Starts to wind up to the next pitch. Here it is. Wide and low, ball one. Makes the count reach 1-1. 1-1 on top of Martin. And for St. Louis, the first half of the first inning. Goes on the mound again. Starts the old wind up for the next pitch. Here it comes, and it's a foul ball going down the right field line up on top of the stand. And the count is two strikes and one ball on Martin. Now the new ball tossed out to low. Martin steps back out of the batter's box. Gonzalez is coaching at third. For St. Louis, Ware is at first. Rowe coming back in on the mound. Gets the signal from the captain. The count is two strikes and one ball. Martin is lined up for the pitch. There it is. And a fly ball. Going down back of the pitcher's mound. All on his after. And he makes the catch about halfway between the pitcher's mound and second base. 41st out. Martin pops out to Rowe. One away. And that brings up Rothrock. The Cardinal right fielder switch hitter batting left-handed against Rowe. Rothrock is hitting 143 in the series. Frisch on deck. Rowe starts his wind up for the initial pitch to Rothrock. And he punts one down the third base line. Owen is after, but the ball rolls foul. Ball rolls foul before it got to third. And it's one strike on Rothrock. One strike is the count. A new ball is tossed out to Rowe. They're waiting on Rothrock to get back to the plate. This is the first half of the first inning. One down, nobody on. One strike is the count. He's on the mound again. That's for the next pitch. Here it comes. And it's a drive down the right field line. It's there. Just inside of the line. Here comes Rothrock racing for second base. There's a throw, and he's safe at second with a double. Rothrock double down the right field line. Brings up manager Frankie Frisch. Cardinal manager and second baseman, another switch hitter, batting left-handed against Rowe. And his average in the series is 227. Rowe's on the mound. He got the signal from Cochran. All set. Here's the pitch. Blackburn called on Frisch. Medwick on deck. This is the first half of the first inning. One strike is a count on Frankie Frisch. Rowe's on the mound again. Gets the signal. Here's the next one. And it's a ground ball. It's a line drive down through Owen. He had a nice catch. The line drive from Frankie Frisch is back to Owen at third base. He didn't didn't have any chance to double Rock Rock there. Gallagher couldn't get over to the bag fast enough. The play was made too quick. Two down. First, lined out to Rowe in the third. That brings up Joe Medlings, the Cardinal left fielder, right-handed hitter. Hitting 381 in the series. Goes on the mound and gets set. Here's the first pitch. And it's a drive out to right field for a hit. Here comes Rock Rock coming in. Here's the throw. And he's in with a run. And Medlings goes down to second on the throw to play. To the plate. Medlings singles to right. Rock Rock scoring. And on Foster's throw to the plate, Medlings moves down to second. Run in. Two down. Medlings on second base. And Rip Collins is up. Cardinal first baseman, a quick hitter, batting left-handed against Rowe. First half of the first inning. One run in. Rowe takes his position on the mound, getting set for the first pitch to Collins. Here it comes. And it's a fly ball going out to deep right. Watts is going back. He runs it. And he makes the catch right in front of the bleachers out there for the third out, retiring the side. Collins out. On a fly, out to Fox and right. The result, the first half of the first inning show, no runs, or rather one run, beg your pardon, two hits, and no errors. And the score now reads one for St. Louis. Going into the last half of the first, with Detroit getting their first chance. And now time for station identification. This is the Columbia Broadcasting System.
WBBM Air Theater, Wrigley Building, Chicago.
Back at Navin Field, going into the last half of the first inning. And JoJo White, the Tigers center fielder, will be the first man up. That's went on deck, and Gehringer will be the third hitter. Paul Dean is on the mound taking his preliminary throws. Great waiting down at second base for the throw. There it is, and we're all set to go. White is up, first man, left-handed hitter, getting 176 in the series. Paul Dean is taking position on the mound, getting a signal from Delancey. The last half of the first inning, Dean starts his wind-up. Here's the pitch. Strike one, Paul. One strike is the count on White. Martin came charging in fast. Thought White was going to attempt to lay one down. One strike is the count on White. Dean's winding up. Here's the next one. All one inside, one and one. One ball and one strike. The last half of the first inning. On the mound again, getting a signal from Delancey. That's your windup for the next pitch. Here it comes. Ball two, outside and high. Two balls and one strike on White. Mickey Cochran on deck. This is the last half of the first. And the score is 1-0 so far in favor of the St. Louis Cardinals. Holding on the mound again. Getting a single from Delancey. Starts the old wind-up for the next pitch. Down to two balls and one strike. And it's a foul into the sand. Down the left field line. And the count is even up now. 2-2. Two balls, two strikes. Umpire slams hands Delancey a new ball when he tosses out the ball deep. 2-2 is the count. On White. First man up for the Tigers. The last half of the first inning. Got the old wind-up again. Here's the next one. And he went down swinging. White struck out for the first out. One away, and that brings up Mickey Cochran. Mickey Cochran is up. The Detroit manager and catcher. Left-handed hitter. And getting a big hand from the fans as he steps up to the plate. Cochran is hitting in the series. 150. One down, nobody on. Baldy's on the mound. Gets the old signal for the initial pitch to Cochran. Here it is. Wide, ball one. Ball is the count on Cochran. Dean starts the old wind-up for the next pitch. Strike one, call. The count is even up. One and one. One ball and one strike. Starts his wind-up for the pitch. Here it is. And it's a ground ball going towards right field. Chris makes a beautiful dive. Diving stop. But not any chance to get Cochran at first base. Had a beautiful diving stop on that ball, but not a chance to get Cochran at first. It's a hit for Cochran. He's on first base, and that brings up Charlie Gehringer. Charlie Gehringer is up. The Detroit second baseman. Left-handed hitter. One man down. Cochran on first base. Gehringer batting. Gehringer's hitting 381 so far in the series. Caldeen's on the mound. Gets up for the first pitch. Here it is. Outside, ball one. One ball is a count on Gehringer. Caldeen on the mound again. Yep. And here's the next one. A ground ball going down to first. And he's out at first. Straight to Collin. Cochran advancing to second. Cochran is on second base. One away. Or rather, two away. And that brings up two stars on the back of left fielder, a left-handed hitter. Starsland is hitting 286 in the series. Two down. Mickey Cochran down on second base. Starsland batting, a left-handed hitter. Rogel on deck. This is the last half of the first inning. Scores 1-0 St. Louis so far. Caldeen on the mound. Here's the pitch, and he swung at it. Strike one on Gosman. One strike on Goose Gosman. With two down. Cochran down on second base. We're in the last half of the first inning. Caldeen on the mound again, getting a signal from Delancey. Standing in the rubber, getting set for the delivery. Cochran coming off the second a little bit. Here's the next one. And it's a whip down to Martin. Martin knocks the ball down. Made a beautiful throw across that first to Collin, and Gosman was out. Points to Collin for the third out, retiring the side. The result, the last half of the first inning, no runs, one hit, and no error. And the score reads 1-0 table as we go into the first half of the second inning. These World Series broadcasts are brought to you through the courtesy of the makers of the Ford V8. Going into the first half of the second inning, and Delancey, the Cardinal catcher, will be the first man up. A left-handed hitter. He'll be followed by Orsani and then DeRozan. Delancey is hitting exactly 200 so far in the series. First half of the second inning coming up. They hit for two for the Cardinals, and one for Detroit so far in the game. Rowe is on the mound, warming up with Hayworth until Mickey Cochran gets out. Delancey is rolling out to the plate, carrying two war clubs. In the last half of the first there, White, the first man for the Tigers, struck out, and Cochran singles. Gehringer was thrown out by Fritz after moving down to second, and then Gosman was thrown out at first, Martin to Collin. We're all set to go in the first half of the second inning. Delancey batting a left-handed hitter. Taking his position on the mound. Calling around in the third out there against the six just right. Delancey steps back out of the batter's box for the moment. This is the first half of the second inning coming up. St. Louis leading 1-0. Delancey is in the batter's box. Rowe's on the mound. He gets a signal from back when he's winding up. And here's the first pitch. And it's a drive going out to left. Looks like it. Dawson going back like it's tight. No, he goes right up against the screen. Makes a beautiful catch. It looked like it was going into the sand for a home run. Dawson went right back against the screen and made a very nice catch. One away. One away. And Orsatti is up. Ernie Orsatti is up. Cardinal center fielder hitting 333 so far in the series. That's left-handed. One down, both charges wind up. Here's the first pitch to Orsatti, a foul to the left of the plate into the sand. One strike, a new ball is tossed there. One strike is a count on Orsatti. Goes on the mound again, expect the old wind up for the next pitch. Here it is, and it's a ground ball down to Owen. Owen comes up with it, and he's out at first. Owen to Greenberg for the second out. Two down. Two down, and that brings up DeRocha, the Cardinal shortstop. DeRocha's average for the series, 111. Right-handed hitter, he followed by Paul D. This is the first half of the second inning, and the score is 1-0 St. Louis at the present time. Rowe takes his position on the mound, getting a signal from Cochran. Winding up, and the ground ball going down to third base. Oh,
one comes in. He makes a nice scoop up. And he threw the ball into the dirt at first base. And Greenberg makes a nice scoop up. Two nice plays on one ball there. As we turn the side, the roach are out. Owen to Greenberg. 23rd out, retiring the side. And the result for the first half of the second inning show. No runs, no hits, and no errors. Quite a contrast there in the fielding in that inning from what happened out here in the first game and also in the fourth game in St. Louis. Gosman making a nice catch there on the first ball on Delancey. And then Owen coming up with a beautiful stop there on DeRozier's slow roll. On the mound, warming up with Delancey. We're going into the last half of the second inning. St. Louis leading by a score of 1-0. Rogel, the back of shortstop, will be the first man up. Greenberg on deck, and Owen will be the third hit. The infielder tossing the ball around. Rogel standing to right of the plate. There goes Delancey, throw down to second, and we're all set to go. The last half of the second inning coming up. Rogel is the only switch hitter in the Tiger lineup, batting left-handed against Paul Deem. Paul Deem is on the mound, getting a signal from Delancey. We're all set to go. Starts the old wind-up for the initial pitch. Here it comes, and it's strike one call. That's one right through the center. One strike is the count on Rogel. Paul Deem winding up for the next one. Ball inside and low. The count is 1-1. One ball and one strike on Rogel. This is the last half of the second inning. The field signal again. And here's the next pitch. Ball two, it was outside. Two balls and one strike. Two balls and one strike is the count on Rogel. Paul Dean on the mound. Starts the old windup. Strike. Ball. They count it 2-2. Two balls and two strikes. Two balls and two strikes. This is the first hitter for the Tigers in the last half of the break. Aldine starts his windup. Here's the pitch. Ball three outside. 2-2. This is the one. Got to be in there this time. This is the one that tells the story. The count is 3-2. It's on the mound. Getting his signal. Winding up to the pitch. And he went down swinging. Rogel was struck out for the initial out. Rogel struck out. That brings up Hank Greenberg. Tiger first baseman, a right-handed hitter, and Greenberg in the series is hitting 350. That's right-handed. Owen on deck. Aldine starts the old wind-up to the pitch. Ball one inside. One ball is a count on Greenberg. Aldine on the mound again. Starts the old wind-up to the next one. Here's the pitch, and another high one. Ball two, and no strikes on Greenberg. Two balls and no strikes with one man down, nobody on. This is the last half of the second inning. St. Louis leading at the present time by a score of 1-0, getting one run in the first inning. Pauline starts his windup. Here's the pitch. Strike. He swung at it. And the count is 2 balls and 1 strike on Greenberg. 2 balls and 1 strike is the count on Hank Greenberg. Getting a signal again for the next one. 2 balls and 1 strike. Here it comes. And he took another cut. And the count is even up 2-2. Balls and two strikes. Teams winding up. Here's the pitch. And he went down swinging. Greenberg struck out for the second out. Two down. And that brings up Marvin Owen, the Tiger third baseman, a right-handed hitter. Owen in the series is hitting 95. Season average 316. Made a beautiful stop out there in the first half of the second. That pick up on DeRozier's ball. It's the first pitch to Owen, a foul into the stands, the upper tier, back of the plate, 4-1 strike. There's two down, nobody on. This is the last half of the second. A new ball across out to Paul Dean. It's on the mound. Starts the old windup for the pitch. Here it is. And it's a ground ball going down to third. Martin takes it, and he's out at third. Martin to Collins, 43rd out, retiring the side. The result, the last half of the second inning show, no runs, no hits, and no errors. And the score going into the first half of the third, the St. Louis 1, Detroit 0. The Ford Motor Company is sending you the broadcast of the World Series game.
First half of the third inning coming up. And the first man up for St. Louis will be Paul D. He'll be followed by Pepper Martin and then Rock Rock. Dean hasn't had any hits in the series so far. Goes on the mound. Taking his preliminary throws with Mickey Thompson. While Detroit infield is tossing the ball around. Here comes Paul Dean now, strolling out to the mound. Getting a nice hand from the fans. The right-handed batter. Rowe is taking his position on the mound. Paul Dean steps into the batter's box. We're all set to go. This is the first half of the third inning. Score 1-0 St. Louis. Goes on the rubber, getting the signal from Mickey Cochran. That's the old wind-up for the initial pitch. Here it comes. And it's a hot grounder down the first baseline. Greenberg comes up with it. Runs over, touching the bag, making the foot out. Unassisted. Aldean is out to Greenberg at first. Unassisted. One away. And that brings up Pepper Martin. Cardinal third baseman, a right-handed hitter. Martin on his other appearance in the first inning. Pops out to Owen, who made the catch back of the pitcher's mound. Right-handed hitter, Rock Rock on deck. The umpires are calling time for a moment. The fans get the overcoats off of the rail and scatter some people out the back of the screen way down the right field line. One down, nobody on, and Pepper Martin up. Geisel is walking about halfway out there. And there's a bunch of boys sitting up on top of the fence out there. They're making them all move out of there. Evidently it's bothering the hitters when they're up to the plate, facing that direction. So in the meantime is still tossing a few back and forth with Mickey Cochran. Just about got him cleared out there. The buildings across the street from the park are doing a very good business this afternoon. They're absolutely jammed. Every window and the roof and up on top of signs and everything else. Still waiting to get the youngsters off of the fence down the right field line. Umpire Geisel is coming back into first base. Pepper Martin stepping into the batter's box. There's one down. Nobody on. Now it's the first half of the third. Rowe's on the mound. He got the signal. He's winding up. And here's the first pitch. Strike one called on Martin. Rock Rock on deck. One strike of the count on Martin. Rowe's winding up again. Here's the next one. Ball inside and high. One and one. One ball and one strike on Pepper Martin. First half of the third inning, St. Louis leading 1-0. All two. Outside and low, he was tempted, though he came very near swinging. The count is 2 balls and one strike. 2 balls and one strike on Pepper Martin. And here's the next one. And it's a hot grounder down to Gehringer. Gehringer comes up with it, and he's out at first. Gehringer to Greenberg, 42nd out. Two down, and that brings up Rob Rock. Rock Rock is up. Cardinals right fielder. This is their second appearance to play. They got a double down the right field line in the first inning. And then scored a little later on Medwick's single to right center. Rose Dodgers wind up for the first pitch to Rock Rock. Inside, ball one. First half of the third inning. Goes back on the mound again. Starting his wind up for the next pitch. Here it comes. Foul. Back of the plate. And the count is 1-1 on Rock Rock. One ball and one strike with two down, nobody off. New ball tossed out to Rowe, standing back to the mound, nothing he's lost off. Puts on his 12 down, steps back up on the mound. Gets his signal from Cochran, he's winding up to the pitch. Here it is, and a ground ball going back over his head, down back to second. Gehringer is after, and he is over at first. Gehringer juggled the ball after getting it back to second. But I think you'll get credit for a hit. It's a hit. It's an infield hit for Rock Rock. He's on first base with two down, and switches up.
It was a hard ball for Geringer to field going over back of second base. He knocked the ball down, but not a chance to get the runner. First batting, left-handed. Rock Rock on first, rolls on the mound getting set. Here's the pitch. And it's a ground ball down to Geringer, and he makes a nice stop, and he's out at first. Geringer's to Greenberg. He went back on the grass, making a beautiful stop on that one, and tossed Fridge out at first base for the out. The result, the first half of the third inning show, no runs, one hit, and no errors. And the score reads 1-0 in favor of St. Louis, going into the last half of the third inning, and this is the Columbia Broadcasting System.
This is the WBBM Theater, Wrigley Building, Chicago.
Back at Navin Field in Detroit, going into the last half of the third inning. And Pete Fox, the Tiger right fielder, will be the first man up for right-handed hitting. Followed by Schoolboy Rowe and then JoJo White. Score is 1-0 St. Louis. There's a throw down to second base. We're all set to go. Umpire Clem is dusting off the plate. Fox batting a right-handed hitter, getting exactly 238 so far in the series. Aldine winding up. Here's the first one, a foul. Back of the plate up against the screen, and the count is one strike on Fox. New ball tossed out to Aldine. He's back on the mound again to get his signal from Delancey. One strike. Starts the old wind-up to the pitch. Here it is. And it's a pop fly. Going down back to the pitcher's mound, DeRocher is after it, and he makes the catch for the out. Fox popped out to DeRocher, who made the catch back of the pitcher's mound. One away, and that brings up Schoolboy Rowe. Rowe is getting a big hand as he strolls out to the plate. Rowe hit 314 during the season. He hasn't had any hits in the series so far. That's right-handed, followed by JoJo White. Aldine's winding up, and here's the first pitch to roll. Strike one, he swung at it. One strike is a count on roll. Aldine winding up for the next one. Ball, it was low, 1-1. One ball and one strike. Here's the next one, and it's outside and high. Ball two and strike one. In the other game, the drill pitch struck out 4 out of 4. Two balls and one strike on roll. One man down. Dean is winding up for the next one. And it's a foul ball. Going down the first baseline. Collins is going after it, but it's into the stand. Into the stand. And the count is even up now. Two strikes and two balls. Two strikes and two balls. A new one is tossed in, going around the Cardinal infield. And Martin is just now tossing the ball into Paul Lee. Two balls and two strikes on roll. One man down. Nobody on. This is the last half of the third. Paul Lee starts the old windup for the pitch. And he goes down swinging. Roll strikes out. 42nd out. Two down. And that brings up JoJo White, the Tiger center fielder, a left-handed hitter. That's four strikeouts for Dean. White is up, left-handed hitter with two down, nobody off. This is the last half of the third inning. The score is St. Louis 1, Detroit nothing at the present time. Aldine's on the mound, getting a signal from Delancey. Winding up for the first pitch to White. Here it comes. Oh, outside and low. One ball is a count on JoJo White. Starts the old windup again for the next pitch. Here it is. Ball two, outside. Two balls and no strikes on White. Two balls and no strikes with two down, nobody on. Back on the mound. Gets the signal from Delancey. White's the left-handed hitter. Struck out on his other attempt to play the first inning. And here's the next pitch. Ball three, wide. 3-0 on JoJo White. Three balls and no strikes. 3-0 is the count. Winding up to the pitch. Ball four outside, and JoJo White walks on four straight pitches.
And that brings up Mickey Conklin. That's the first base on ball to be issued in the game. Goes to JoJo White, and incidentally, JoJo White has probably had more walks than anyone else in the series. Makes the seventh base on ball that White has drawn during the series. Mickey Cochran batting, got a single in the first inning. Left-handed hitter, Aldine on the mound getting set. There goes the throw to first base, but White is back to the bag. White is on first base, two down, and Cochran batting. Geringer on deck. Aldine's on the mound. Here's the pitch, and there he goes down to second, and he's called out. And then third comes to the ball, and then White ran over to third while the ball was floating around on the ground. White is over third. It's an error on the play. For the moment. Rick will get an error on the play on dropping that ball. However, White came in there pretty fast. It's kind of a hard one to handle. One strike is the count on Conklin. Time is called as a little conference out at the mound. White is on third base. Count of one strike on Cochran, two down. Aldine's on the mound, awaiting on Delancey to hoist his shin guard, and Collins comes in. He also gets credit for a stolen base on that play, but the error comes in where it allowed White to advance from second to third. One strike on Cochran. Aldine is on the mound, getting a signal from Delancey. Starts his wind up to the pitch. There it is, and it's a ground ball. Going down to first base, Mark Collins steals the ball, and pass to Aldine at first, and he's called safe at first, right scoring. White scores, Cochran is on first base. Cochran was hurt on the play, hurt his knee on the play, down on the back. All of the players are running out there, as well as the trainer. Score is tied up now, 1-1. White's run that he just scored here a moment ago was about the same as he did in the one previous game there. In the fourth game, when he got on, stole the base, he came all the way around the third, and then came in on a wild pitch. However, he got around that far this time and scored on Cochran's ground ball down to Collins there that went as an infield hit. Aldine went over to cover the bag, but he beats the throw by a fraction. White scores. Cochran is on first base. Cochran was hurt on the play. Hurt his knee on the play. Down on the bag. All of the players are running out there, as well as the trainer. Score is tied up now, 1-1. White's run that he just scored here a moment ago was about the same as he did in the one previous game there. In the fourth game, when he got on, stole the base, he came all the way around the third, and then came in on a wild pitch. However, he got around that far this time and scored on Cochran's ground ball down to Collins there that went as an infield hit. Aldine went over to cover the bag, but he beats the throw by a fraction. And it went as a hit for Cochran, makes two hits for Cochran, and White scored the tying run. They're running out to first base kid out first base line now. The trainer is out there to work on Cochran. All of the players off of both teams are gathered out around the first base line. Hayworth is warming up down in front of the Detroit dugout. In case Cochran doesn't stay in the game, why Hayworth will go in to do the catch. On one play as we zoom, Charlie Gehringer will be the hitter for the Tigers, with Mickey Cochran on first base, of course, providing that he stays in the game, is able to stay in. They're still working on him. Down around the first baseline. All the players are gathered out there. Both teams, all with the exception of the outfielders. Delancey is coming back to the plate. Paul Dean coming back out to the mound, evidently to take a few preliminary throws and keep warmed up a little. Buzzy Wears, the Cardinal coach, came out to say a few words to Paul Dean on the mound. Cochran is coming up on his feet, and they're walking him around now, whether he's going to try to stay in or not. Getting a big hand from the fans as he gets up and walks around. Baker and Perkins, the two coaches, are walking him around out there. Evidently, he's going to try and stay in. And Gehringer will be the hitter one play as we go. Charlie Gehringer, the Tiger second baseman, a left-handed hitter. Mickey Cochran evidently is going to stay in. He's going back over on first base. The players are coming back. There's two or three of them staying out around the bag there, so. Gehringer on his other appearance at the plate in the first inning was thrown out at first by Frankie Fritz. Score side, 1-1. One ball, or rather, 1-1 is the count with a man on first base. Gehringer up. Cochran's going to stay in. Getting set to go. Martin coming back out of third base. Gehringer steps into the batter's box. Takes it back over to third. The coach at the third baseline for the Tigers. Perkins at first. And we're all set to go. Paul Dean is on the mound, getting a signal from Delancey. Getting set for the delivery. Here's the pitch. And it's strike one call on Gehringer. One strike is a count on Charlie Gehringer. This is the last half of the third. Cochran's taking the lead off first. Here's the next pitch. Strike two. Another one called on Gehringer. Two strikes is a count on Charlie Gehringer. Mickey Cochran on first base. All Dean's on the mound. Gets a signal from Delancey. It's all set for the delivery. Here's the pitch. And a foul over near the Tiger dugout. New ball is tossed in. This is the last half of the third inning. Score tied, 1-1. Paul Dean takes his position on the mound. Getting a single from Delancey for the next pitch. Two strikes to the count. Up goes his arms. He's all set. Here it is. Ball outside and high. Two strikes and one ball. That one came very near being a wild pitch. Paul Dean goes to the rosin bag. He's back on the mound again. Two strikes and one ball is the count. All set. Here it is. And it's a drive going out to deep right. Rock is back at 100. And he takes care of it. 43rd out, retiring the side. Gehringer out on a fly out to Rock in right field. The results from the last half of the third inning show one run, one hit, and one error. Which was charged up to Frankie Fritz. Now the score is going to the first half of the fourth is tied up 1-1.
And that's the end of the third inning of this World Series baseball game between the Cardinals and the Tigers, being played here at Navin Field, Detroit. This broadcast comes to you with the compliments of the Ford Motor Company and the Ford Dealers of America. And back to the ball game with Frank Law.
The first half of the fourth inning coming up. White is getting a big hand as he goes out to his position in center field. Rowe is on the mound, warming up with Hayworth until Mickey Cochran gets on his catching paraphernalia and gets out to the plate. The first man to face Rowe here in the first half of the fourth inning will be Medley. Cochran is getting a big hand now as he comes out to the plate. Medley, first man up for the Cardinals in the first half of the fourth, with a score tied 1-1. Medwick has one hit so far in the game, one out of one, getting a single in the first inning. Rowe taking his position on the mound. Getting a single from Mickey Cochran. Starts the old windup for the first pitch to Medwick. All one. He started the swing, changed his mind, the pitch was low.
One ball is a count on Medley. Rip Collins on deck. So starts the old windup for the next one. Here's the pitch. Strike. He swung at it. One and one. One ball and one strike on Medley. One ball and one strike. Score tied up. One and one. The first half of the fourth. Goes on the mound again. He starts the old windup for the next pitch. Here it comes. And it's a ground ball back over his head going out to center field. For a hit. And Medley is on first base. Medley gets a single to center. That's his second hit. Two straight hits for Medley. And that brings up Rip Collins, the Cardinal first baseman. Switch hitter, batting left-handed. Collins was out on a fly, out to Fox in right field in the first inning. Delancey on deck. Goes on the mound, getting set for the first pitch to Collins. Batting left-handed. Here it comes. Strike one, call. One strike of the count on Rip Collins. This is the first half of the fourth. Ball game is tied up 1-1. One strike. Goes back on the mound again. Set for the next one. Here's the pitch. Ball. Inside and high. 1-1. One ball and one strike on Rip Collins. Still Medley on first base. Nobody out. Goes on the mound again. Set for the next pitch. Here it is. Out of the ground ball. Down to Jennifer. Jennifer is close to the ground. At second base. Forcing Medley. Medley forced out of second base. Going to Rogel. Collins on first base. Result of the fielder choice. And Delancey is up. Delancey is up. Cardinal catcher. He was out on the fly. Out to Garvin. On his first trip to the plate in the second inning. Orsatti on deck. This is the first half of the fourth inning. Score tied 1-1. Collins on first base. One man down. Rowe takes his position on the mound again. Gets his signal from Thompson. For the first pitch to Delancey. Here it is. Ball outside. One ball is a count on Delancey. One ball is a count on Delancey. Goes back on the mound again. Gets his signal for the next one. Here's the pitch. Fire. Up on top of the stands to the left of the plate. And the count is 1-1. One ball and one strike on Delancey. 1-1 is the count. One ball and one strike. Rowe takes his position on the mound. Gets his signal from Conklin. Here it comes. And a foul. Back against the screen. The count is two strikes and one ball. Two strikes and one ball is a count on Delancey with one man down and Rip Collins down on first base. Goes on the mound. Gets the old signal for the next pitch. Strike three. Delancey went down swinging. 42nd out. That's the first man for Rowe to strike out. Two down. Collins on first. That brings up Orsatti, the Cardinal center fielder, left-handed hitter. Orsatti was thrown out by Owen on his other appearance at the plate in the second inning. Dulocher on deck. Goes on the mound, getting set. Here's the pitch. All one. Wide. One ball is a count on Orsatti. This is the first half of the fourth. The old ball game is tied up 1-1. Goes back on the mound, getting a signal for the next pitch. There's a throw to first base. Collins is back to the bag. Greenberg is passing the ball back into Rowe. Coming in on the mound. Getting set for the next pitch to Orsatti. One ball is a count. Here it comes. And it's a dry fly ball. Out to left field. Gosman is at it. And he takes care of it. Body filled out. Retiring the side. Orsatti is out on a fly to Gosman and left. The result, the first half of the fourth inning shows no run. One hit. And no air. And the score reads 1-1. Going into the last half of the fourth inning. And Zeus Gosman, the Tiger left fielder, is scheduled to be the first hitter. With Rogel on deck and Greenberg in the hole. Cardinals are out on the field. Paul Dean is just strolling out to the mound. Delancey is waiting for him there to take preliminary throws. Infield is tossing the ball around. Gosman is over picking out a war club. Throwing out to the plate.
Goslin, Rogel, and Greenberg will be the first three hitters. Goslin on his other fence to play in the first inning. Was thrown out at first by Pepper Martin. Did a hard ground ball down the third baseline. Martin knocked it down and threw him out at first. There goes the Delancey throw down to first at second, and we're all set to go in the last half of the fourth inning. The ball game tied up 1-1. Umpire Clem is dusting off the plate. Sedgwick has just tied the record of 9 singles in a series when he got that last single. That tied the record. Paul Dean gets his signal. He's winding up to the pitch. Here it is. And it's a ground ball. Down the street. And he's out at first. Breaks to Collins. For the initial out. Dawson grounded out on the first pitch. And that brings up Rogel, the banker shortstop. Switch hitter. Starting left-handed against Paul Dean. The second appearance is played. He's struck out in the second inning. Followed by Greenberg. One down. Nobody on the last half of the fourth. Paul Dean on the mound. Starts the old windup for the first pitch. Here it comes. Right one. Call on Rogel. One strike on Rogel with one down, nobody on. The last half of the fourth inning. Paul Dean gets his signal. He's winding up. And it's a foul ball. Going over to the right of the plate. Delancey is after it. And he makes the catch for the second out. Rogel fouled out to Delancey. That brings up Hank Greenberg, the Tiger first baseman, a right-handed hitter. Greenberg struck out on his other appearance to play the second inning. He'll be followed by Owen. Umpire Clem is looking the ball over. Just wind up for the first pitch to Greenberg. Ball one, wide. One ball is a count on Greenberg. This is the last half of the fourth. Going tied up 1-1. He's on the mound again. Gets the old signal for the next one. Winding up, and here it comes. And it's a fly ball. Going down the left field line. It's going foul. Martin is after it. And DeRocher makes the catch. Martin has judged the ball. And DeRocher came in back of it and made the catch down the left field line. 43rd out, retiring a drive. That one was rather funny there, the way that worked out. The result, the last half of the fourth inning show, no runs, no hits, and no errors, and the score reads 1-1 going into the first half of the fifth inning. This broadcast is sponsored by the makers of Ford and Lincoln Cars and Ford Trucks. First half of the fifth inning coming up. St. Louis is back, and DeRocher will be the first man with Dean on deck, and Martin, the third hitter. Throw is out on the mound. Stockman just throwing out to the plate. Takes preliminary throws while the Tiger infield tosses the ball around. Both pitchers are pitching great ball so far in this game. Throw is allowed 4 hits, and Paul Dean is allowed 2. Dean has walked one man. Rowe hasn't walked any. Leo DeRocher is the first man up for St. Louis, the first half of the fifth inning. Second time at the plate in this game. He's thrown out by Owen in the second inning. Rowe is on the mound, getting his signal. Starts the old windup for the first pitch to DeRocher. Here it comes, and it's a ground ball. Down to Ganger, knocks the ball down, and there goes the play, but it's too late to get him, and it looks like it'll be recorded as a hit for DeRocher. It's a hit for DeRocher, and he's on first base. DeRocher gets a hit off of Geringer's glove, back to second. He's on first base. Geringer came very near making a beautiful stop on that one. He went over there plenty far to get a hold of that ball, rather than knock it down. Paul Dean coming up to the plate. Second appearance, he grounded out to Greenberg unassisted in the third inning. Right-handed hitter with DeRocher on first base, Martin on deck. On the mound getting set for the first pitch to Paul Dean, and he bumps one down the first base line. Greenberg picks up the bar and runs back to the bag, making the put out unassisted.
Four base game, very near pulling a pass from that. Greenberg was sliding down to the back, slot up playing interception. Barney picked up speed, and he does like to fracture the beating Greenberg to the back. 0-2 is on second. One down, and Pepper Martin is up. One down, Pepper Martin batting. This is Martin's third appearance to play. He hasn't any hits so far in this game. Popped out to Warren in the first inning, which made the catch back to the pitcher's mound. And in the third inning, he was thrown out at first by Charlie Gehringer. Derosa down on second base. One man down. Martin batting with Rock Rock on deck. And this is the first half of the fifth with the score tied 1-1. Rose on the mound, getting ready for the first pitch to Martin. Here it comes. Strike one call. One strike on Pepper Martin. First half of the fifth inning. Derosa down on second base. Rose takes his position on the mound again, getting set for the next pitch. Here it comes. And it's a hit. Out to right field, a ground single. Here comes Derosa. Osmond is coming in with the throw. Here it comes. And he's in. With a run, the ball gets back up and going back to the screen. And Martin comes all the way around to third. Somebody will get an error on that one. It'll allow Martin to advance from second to third on it. Derosa scored on Martin's single out to left. And then Martin, on the next bat, throw at the plate, comes all the way around. It's an error. Probably on Jasmine throw from the outfield. Jasmine gets the error on the throw. At the run in, Martin on third base, one down, and Rock Rock batting. Here's the pitch to Rock Rock. Strike one, he swung at it. The infield is in close, clear in on the grass in case he hasn't hit a ground ball if they have a chance to touch Martin off at the plate. Here's the next pitch to Rock Rock. Ground ball down to Rogel. Rogel feels the ball. He's out at first. Has Martin scored. Rock Rock was out at first. Rogel at the Greenberg. Has Martin crosses the plate with a run. Two down. Two down, and Frankie Frisch is up. And the score is now 3-1 in favor of St. Louis, the first half of the fifth inning. Frankie Frisch is the next hitter for the Cardinals. A five slam dusting off the plate. There's two down, nobody on. Nedwick on deck. Nedwick, as we told you, has a record tied on singles for the series. And he's got a chance to break that his next time up. He has nine singles in his series. Here's the first pitch to Frisch. Foul ball. Stockman is going after it. Over to the left of the plate. And he takes care of it. For the third out, retiring the side. Frisch fouled out to Stockman. The result of the first half of the fifth inning shows two runs, two hits, and one error, which was charged up to Goblin on that throw to the plate. Now we have time for station identification. This is the Columbia Broadcasting System.
This is the WBBM Theater, Wrigley Building, Chicago.
Back at Navin Field in Detroit, going into the last half of the fifth inning with the Tigers at bat. And Marvin Owen, the Tigers third baseman, will be the first man up with Pete Fox on deck and Schoolboy Rowe in the hole. Aldine is on the mound, warming up with Delancey. Marvin Owen standing right for the plate there, waiting for him to make his throw down, and the umpire to call play ball and start. There goes the throw down to Frisch at second. Owen steps into the batter's box. The umpire is dusting off the plate. And we're all set to go in the last half of the fifth inning. Owen's second appearance is played. In the second inning, he was thrown out at first by Pepper Martin. Aldine starts his windup for the first pitch to Owen. Right, he swung at it, and how. He had all the intentions in the world of lifting that one right out in the bleachers. One strike is a count on Owen. Aldine on the mound again, getting a signal from Delancey. Winding up to the next pitch. Here it comes, and it's fly ball going out to center field. Orsani has answered, and he takes care of it for the first out. Owen out on a fly out to Orsani in center. One away, that brings up Pete Fox, the Tiger right fielder. Fox is up, This is second appearance. He pops out to DeRozier. Back to the pitcher's mound in the third inning. Rowe on deck. The last half of the fifth. Aldine's on the mound. He's winding up to the pitch. Here it comes. Ball one inside. One ball is a count on Fox. One ball is a count. The last half of the fifth inning. He's winding up. Here's the next one. Foul back against the tree. One and one. One ball and one strike on Fox with one down, nobody on. Aldine's on the mound again. Starts the old windup for the next pitch. Here it comes. Ball two, outside and low. Two balls and one strike. Two balls and one strike is the count on Fox. He starts his windup. Here's the pitch. And it's a fly ball. Going out to center field. Orsatti has answered. And he takes care of it for the second out. Fox flies out to Orsatti in center. Two straight put out for Orsatti. And that brings up Schoolboy Rowe. Rowe coming up to the plate. His second appearance. He struck out in the third inning. The right-handed hitter. Score is now 3-1 in favor of St. Louis. Aldine's on the mound. He's winding up to the pitch. Strike one called. One strike is a count on Rowe. Aldine on the mound again. Winding up for the next one. And it's a drive. Out to center field. And Orsatti makes a beautiful running catch coming over to left center. For the third out, retiring the tag. Boy, we've expect that one hard. It looked like a nice double going out there. There's a peculiar inning. Orsatti in center field gets all three put out. That's tied the record in the third. And going in to score, the result there shows no runs, no hits, no errors. And going into the first half of the sixth, the score reached 10-03, Detroit 1. The nationwide broadcast of the World Series games are brought to you by the Ford Motor Company. First half of the sixth inning coming up, and Joe Medwick will be the first man up for St. Louis, the right-handed hitter. He has two hits out of two trips, and with this prepared to the plate, if he gets a single, he will break the record on the most number of singles in a series. He'll be followed by Rip Collins and then Delancey, the St. Louis captain. There's Macklin slow down to Gellinger at second base. Gellinger crosses to Rogel. Rogel in too low, and we're all set to go. Medwick is just falling up to the plate. He steps into the batter's box. The right-handed hitter, he has two hits. Out of two trips, singles in the first and fourth inning. Rowe is on the mound. Getting a signal from Mickey Thompson, winding up to the pitch. There's the first one. Strike one called. He started to swing, changed his mind, and it was a called strike. One strike on Medley. Rowe starts his lineup for the next pitch. Here it comes. High, ball one. One ball and one strike on Medley. One ball and one strike is a count. Rowe is winding up for the next one. There's the pitch. Strike two. Medwick swung at it. Two strikes and one ball. Two strikes and one ball is a count on Medwick. Rowe starts the old windup. Ball two, outside and high. Two balls and two strikes on Medwick. First man up for the Cardinals. The first half of the sixth inning. Rowe is back on the mound again. Gets a signal from Thompson. He's winding up. Here it comes. And he went down swinging. Medwick struck out. Bobby first out. That's the second man for Rowe to whip. That brings up Rip Collins. North first baseman. Collins hasn't any hits so far in the game. Batting left-handed. Rowe is winding up for the pitch. There it is. And he swung at it. Strike one on Collins. One strike is a count on Rip Collins. Rowe starts to wind up for the next pitch. There it is. Strike two, Collins. Count on Rip Collins with one down, nobody off. And he's winding up again. Here it comes. And it's high. Ball one. Two strikes and one ball. Two strikes and 1 ball is a count. Onward, Collins. Delancey on deck. Both starters wind up. Here's the next pitch. Ball two. The pitch was inside and lower. The count is even up. Onward, Collins, 2-2. Rowe has the ball. He's back out there, standing back of the mound. Now he comes in on the rubber. That's the old wind-up for the pitch. The count is 2-2. Here it is. And he went down swinging. Collins struck out. 42nd out. Two straight strikeouts. And that brings up Delancey, the Cardinals catcher, a left-handed hitter. Delancey is up. Delancey is a left-handed hitter. There's two down. Delancey struck out his last play in the fourth inning. Rowe is winding up. Here's the first pitch to Delancey. And it's a fly ball. Going out to left field, Gosselin is after it, hunts it, and he makes the catch. He came very near dropping it. It bounced up in his glove, but he managed to hang on. And retired the side with no runs, no hits, and no error. And the scores are going to be last half of the sixth inning. 3-1 in favor of St. Louis. The last half of the sixth coming up. And JoJo White will be the first hitter for Detroit, followed by Mickey Thompson, and then Charlie Garrison. We have time for station identification. This is the Columbia Broadcasting System.
This is the WBBM Air Theater, Wrigley Building, Chicago.
Back at Navin Field, going into the last half of the sixth inning. White, Hodson, and Geringer will be the first three hitters for the Tigers in the last half of the stretch. There goes the throw down to second base. We're all set to go. White has been at the plate twice. He struck out in the first inning, walked in the third, then went down to second. And on first, dropped the ball down there. He moved on around the third, after which he scored on Mickey Cochran's infield hit to Collins. Aldine is getting a signal from Delancey, winding up to the first pitch to White. Ball one, wide. 1 ball is a count. 1 ball is a count on JoJo White, a left-handed hitter. Aldine starts the old wind-up for the next one. Ball two, outside. Seems like all of these pitchers have a tough time pitching to White. He gets more walks than any of them. He's already had 8 walks in the series. 7 walks in the series. Black Swan is tying the record. Dean is winding up. Here's a pitch. Strike called. 2 balls and 1 strike. 2 balls and 1 strike is the count. This is the first man for the Tigers in the last half of the pitch. Dean's winding up. Here's the next one. Ball three inside. 3-1. He's got a mighty good chance to tie that record. 3-1 is a count. He's got to get 2 of them in there. Winding up. All four. Going wide. White walk. And if we're not mistaken, that ties the record of 8 walks in a series game. Cochran. Here's the next man at the plate for the Tigers. Cochran has the only hit for the Tigers so far in this ball game. Singles in the first and third innings. The left-handed hitter. Aldine's on the mound, getting set for the first pitch to Cochran. And it's a ground ball. Here's a pitch. Strike one call on Geringer. One strike as they count on Johnny Gallagher. Dodson on deck. This is the last half of the sixth. With a score leading 3-1 in favor of St. Louis at the present time. Beans on the mound. Here's the pitch. Maddox is down for it.
The result, the last half of the sixth inning, so score two runs.
One run, two hits, and no error.
And St. Louis is again in the lead by a score of 4-3 going into the last half of the seventh inning.
We have time for station identification. This is the Columbia Broadcasting System.
This is the WBBM Air Theater, Wrigley Building, Chicago.
The third.
result of the last half of the seventh inning show. No runs, one hit, and no errors. And the score, going into the first half of the eighth, leads St. Louis 4, Detroit 3. These World Series broadcasts are brought to you through the courtesy of the Ford Motor Company. Frankie Prince will be the first man up for St. Louis in the first half of the eighth inning, followed by Nedley, Evan Collins. The hits in the game are 8 for St. Louis, 5-44. Dodson made one error on a bad throw to the plate for the Tigers. Prince and Paul Dean making errors for the St. Louis team. Lower takes the preliminary throws with Hayworth. Coming out to the plate, Mickey Cochran just throwing out. There's a throw down to second base. Hayward making the throw. We're all set to go. First half of the eighth inning, great batting. This is Chris's fourth appearance at the plate this afternoon. He hasn't any hit. Quick hitter, batting left-handed against Rowe. Score is 4-3. Favor the Cardinals. This is the first half of the eighth. Rowe is on the mound. Starts his windup to the first pitch to Chris. And it's a foul down the first baseline, fouled by about 6 inches right down the first baseline, and it's strike one on three. New ball is tossed out to Schoolboy Rowe. One strike of the count on three, Nedley's on deck. This is the first half of the eighth inning. Chris steps back into the batter's box. Rowe starts his windup. Here's the pitch. And it's a ground ball. Running down to short, Rogel takes it on a big hop, and he is out at first. Rogel to Greenberg. One down. Greenberg making a nice pickup out of the dirt. On the way, that brings up Medley, the Cardinal left fielder, a right-handed hitter. With Collins on deck. Rogel starts his windup for the first pitch to Medley. Fowler. He was ducking that one, it hit his back. Two balls are sent. One strike is the count on Medley. Rowe starts the old windup to the next one. Here's the pitch. And a foul ball going down the first baseline. Greenberg is going after it, but not a chance to get to that one. Just a little bit out of his reach. They count as two strikes on Medley. The new ball tossed in. Two strikes to the count. Medley went over to exchange back. Two strikes. One man down, nobody on. And this is the first half of the eighth inning. Back to the batter's box. Rowe is on the mound. Getting a signal from Conklin. Winding up to the pitch. Two strikes to the count. Here it comes. Ball outside and low. One ball and two strikes. Ball and two strikes. That's the old windup for the next pitch. Here it is. And a foul to the right of the plate, going up on top of the stand. And the count is still two strikes and one ball on Medley. Another new one tossed out to Rowe, standing back of the mound, rubbing the cloth off of the ball. Comes in on the mound to get his signal. Winding up. Here's the pitch. And another foul. Back against the screen. Still two strikes and one ball. This is the first half of the eighth inning, and St. Louis leading by a score of 4-3. So it's coming in on the rubber again. Gets his signal, winding up to the pitch. Starts to... There it is. And it's a ground ball. Down to Greenberg. Greenberg comes up with it. And he is out at first. Greenberg unassisted. That's two down. Two down. And Rick Collins, the Cardinal first baseman, is up. Left-handed hitter. That is batting left-handed against Rowe. Two away. This is the first half of the eighth inning. From Johnson, winding up to the first pitch to Collins. Ball, it was high. One ball is a count on Rip Collins. Rowe is on the mound again, up for the next one. Here's the pitch, and a foul up on top of the stand to the left of the plate. One strike and one ball is a count on Collins.
strike.
With two down, nobody on the last, or rather the first half of the eighth inning. And here's the next pitch to Collins. Strike two, he swung at it. Two strikes to the count. Two strikes and one ball. Both starts wind up again for the next pitch. And a foul into the sand to the left of the plate. Now the man's the same, two strikes and one ball. Another new one in. This is the first half of the eighth inning. Taylor is leading by 4-3. Rowe standing back at the mound. He comes in on the rubber again to get his signal from Cochran. Two strikes and one ball is the count. He's winding up. Here's the pitch, and it's a fly ball. Going down back to third base. Marvin Owen going back at it, and he makes the catch out in short left. Back to third, for a third out, retiring the side. The result, the first half of the eighth inning show, no runs, no hits, and no errors. On the score reads St. Louis 4, Detroit 3, going into the last half of the eighth, and Mickey Cochran is scheduled to be the first hitter for the Tigers. Gehringer on deck, and Garth is in the hole. Got their three big guns up this inning. Cochran has had three hits out of three trips. He was batting there in the seventh when White was thrown out attempting to steal second. The last half of the eighth inning, Mickey Cochran will be the first hitter. Aldine is on the mound, warming up with Delancey. Cochran is strolling out to the plate. There goes Delancey's throw down the plate at second base. Teams are fighting hard for this game. The Cardinals win, it means they're tied up with the Tigers, and they fight the deciding game tomorrow. The Tigers win, it's all over with, and they will be the new world champions. Mickey Cochran at the plate, left-handed hitter. Dean's on the mound, getting a signal from Delancey. Starts the old wind-up for the first pitch. Strike one called on Cochran. One strike is a count. Cochran has been at the plate three times, and he has three hits. Singles in the first, third, and sixth. Dean starts his wind-up for the next one. And it's a ground ball. Going down to first. First comes up with it. He's out at first. Strike to Collins for the initial out. Cochran grounded out. Strike to Collins. One away, and that brings up Charlie Gehringer, the Tigers' second baseman. Gehringer scored a run in the sixth inning. He had a little easy roller back to Paul Dean. Paul Dean let it go between his legs, and it resulted in a couple runs before the inning was over. The left-handed hitter, Dean starts his wind-up for the pitch. Here's the first one, and it's a ground ball. Going down toward right, Chris goes after it, and he's safe. Safe at first, beat it out. One infield hit, Chris went back on the ground, made a quick throw, but Gehringer beat it by a fraction. Gehringer on first base, one down, and Goslin is up. Goslin is up. Tiger left fielder, left-handed hitter. Aldean on the mound getting set. Here's the pitch. Strike, he swung at it. One strike of the count on Goslin. Gehringer on first base, one down. This is the last half of the eighth inning. Aldean on the mound again, getting a signal from Delancey. For the next one, the score is 4-3 St. Louis. This is the last half of the eighth. Aldean's on the mound set. There he turns and makes the throw over to first base. Ball's back into Dean. He's on the mound again. Another throw to first. Gehringer was back plenty to spare. On the mound, getting set for the pitch. Here it comes. And it's a drive. Out to right field. For a hit. And Gehringer pulls up at third. Goslin singles to right center, sending Gehringer to third. And that brings up Rogel. That brings up Rogel. Tiger shortstop. Time is called for the moment. Cardinals for a little conference with Dean. Go
Good hitter batting left-handed against Faldy. Rogel batting. Geringer on third. Goslin on first. That was Goslin's third hit of the afternoon. Faldy on the mound. The infield's in close. Here's the pitch. Ball one. Wide. One ball is a count. On Rogel. Infield is in close in case he hits the ground ball. Chance to cut off a runner at the plate. Dean's on the mound again, getting a signal from Delancey. Ball two. It was wide. Two balls and no strikes. Two balls and no strikes is the count on Rogel. Aldine back on the mound again, getting a signal from Delancey for the next one. All set for the delivery. Here it is, and it's a fly ball. Going out to center field. Orsatti coming in after it. Ganger holding up. Here he comes. And he started in, but he went back when Orsatti makes a perfect throw to the plate. He really made a beauty on that one. That's two down. Two down, and Hank Greenberg is up. The tag at first base. Conference out on the pitcher's mound. Martin, Sprint, Delancey, and Faldy. And we wouldn't be a bit surprised there to see Greenberg purposely pass. Greenberg's a right-handed hitter. He has one hit out of three trips, getting a single in the sixth inning. Calls in a run. Two down. Geringer on third base. Goslin on first base. This is the last half of the eighth. And St. Louis leading by a score of 4-3. Aldine's on the mound, getting set for the first pitch to Greenberg, a right-handed hitter. All set. There it is. Strike one call. One strike. For the pitch to him. One strike is a count on Greenberg. Aldine getting a signal from Delancey again. Here's the next one. And it's a foul ball. Going down the first baseline. Collins is out it. But it's... And he makes a beautiful catch going over to the boxes. He made a nice catch over there on that one. 43rd out, retiring the side. The result, the last half of the eighth inning show no runs, two hits, and no errors. And the score, going into the first half of the ninth inning, Reed Saylor 4, Detroit 3.
The Ford Motor Company, which is sending you these World Series broadcasts, hopes that you are enjoying the game.
And now we're going to turn the microphone over to Pat Flanagan, who will carry on here in the ninth inning.
Okay, Pat. There's Brent. How about you, ladies and gentlemen? The first man coming to bat for the St. Louis Cardinals will be Delancey, who has been at bat three times this afternoon, has struck out once and flied out twice to Goslin.
He has far been trained by Orsatti, who has gone out once to the infield from third base to first, has flied out once to left and flied out to center. Following Orsatti, we have DeRocher, who has gone out from third to first, singled once, doubled once, and scored both times that he got hit. At the present time, the hits are even, Dean and Rowe each having given seven hits. Eight for Dean, I believe it is. 2-4-6-7, 2-4-6-6. Rowe has given eight hits, Dean has given seven. Of Rowe's 54 runs have scored, of Dean's 53 runs have scored. The man at the bat right now is Delancey. First ball tipped to Delancey, he swings at it for a strike. One strike to Delancey, catches, is hitting left-handed. Delancey was a switch batter during the year, but since the season got near the end, he began to hit left-handed entirely. Next ball is a slow one, coming down and nipping the outside corner at the hip for strike two. Two strikes to Delancey. Rowe takes his next time from tapping. Better to the border six. Delancey swings at that one for strike three. 3-6 balls and he's down, which makes the fourth strikeout for Rowe this afternoon. Next man coming to bat is Orsatti, the center fielder. We have told you what he has done at bat today.
Right now, it's one man down, nobody on, a horse shot at bat, first to the ninth, and 43 in favor of St. Louis Cardinals. First ball, 50, Winnie Fowles is back to the left of the plate, up into the upper deck, and it's strike one. One strike to Winnie Osotti. Rowe takes a new ball, rubs it up Sterling, steps out of the line and gets his time to pitch out of Osotti, and he's down there waiting for it. Here's a pitch. The ball goes back in the farther, back towards second base, passes behind second base, and goes for a single. Osotti singles to center field. That's making whip number 9 off the pitching of Rowe. Man on first base, Joe Osher coming to bat. Osotti singles to center. With one down, with a man on base, Durocher coming to bat, right-hand hitter, waiting for Rowe to pitch the first one, which comes in a little bit wide for the ball. That's to make the safe throw toward first base, but Osotti comes back and won't throw his name. Durocher watching for another one to come in here. Rowe stretches, looks toward first, where Osotti's taking the lead. Here's the pitch. There goes the ball down toward right field. Looks like it's going far. It does. A hard foul, line drive. And Osotti limps all the way around the third. That bad ankle he's had since the first game. We're starting with the third, but he's on his way back across the infield now, going over to first base. The wish to get a line drive foul way down the right field foul line. Fielders again taking their places. Shortstop has just come in to say a few words to Rowe. Now he's starting back to his position. He's coming over deep toward the second base. Ready for the pitch to the Rocher. Runner on first, one down. Here's the pitch. With the right back toward second base. It goes for a hit. Osotti comes over to second base. He starts for third. The throw is coming down to third base. He comes into the bag and twists his leg badly as he goes into it. But swings around and gets up as the ball is missed on the throw. The ball came in, and just as he got there, now he's down on his hands and knees with his head on his hands. He apparently twisted that leg quite badly as he went in. The Rocher on a throw down to third base, went on over to second. We have a man on second, a man on third, one man down. The Rocher is given credit for a single. Goes down to second base on the throw to third. The man is safe on the throw to third. The ball coming in, struck against Owen's arm and bouncing off over the foul line. So we have a man on second, a man on third. Paul Dean coming to bat with one man down. The score, 4-3 in favor of the St. Louis Cardinals in the first half of the night. Paul Dean has laid down a sacrifice, single once this afternoon. Gone out once to the infield. First baseman on the fifth. He swings at the first ball pitch slip. Infield throwing in close for a pair at the plate with one down and two on. Runners on second and third taking their lead. Paul Dean's waiting for Rowe to pitch. He hits one down toward the second baseman. The throw is made at the plate, and the runner is called out at the plate as he comes dashing in. We have Osotti out of the plate. On a throw from second baseman Zerwin. Now the catcher Cochran. On the play, the Rocher moves over to third. Paul Dean is safe on first base on the fielder's choice. Makes two men down and brings the head of the batting list, Mr. Martin, up to bat. Trevor Martin, who has had one single this afternoon, flied out to right, has also gone out to the third baseman on a fly, and has gone out from second to first. St. Louis has a man in scoring position over on third base, two down, a man on first base, and Martin coming to bat. Martin coming up to bat. Rowe gets his time to pitch to Trevor Martin. Just as he got the sign, we find Captain Cochran stepping back and commencing to talk to umpire Quinn. Cochran hurt himself at first base this afternoon, and he was jarred pretty heavily that time when Osotti threw his body against him as he came in. Lost the chance, of course, in doing that, hitting the plate and making the man drop the ball at the same time, but Mickey's too good a catcher for that. Man on first, man on third, two down on Martin at bat. Rowe gets ready to pitch. Swing time. Glances over his left shoulder towards first, where Dean is leading. Here's the pitch. Up and Martin takes a fast strike, hooking the outside corner just above the knees. Strike one. One strike to the old couple pot. Runner on third starts his lead. Here's the pitch. He started for that one, changed his mind, and took it low. Ball on and strike one to Martin. Martin at bat with DeRocher on third, Paul Dean over on first, and two down in the first half of the night. Looks toward first. Here's a pitch to Pepper Martin. He calls one high up into the stands. And it's ball one and strike two. The pitch is out ahead of him. The new baseball is shot in immediately. Cochran throwing the ball in. Rowe steps back, rubs the ball a little bit. Turns his back to the hitter. Much the same manner that Jazzy Vance does.
when he's pitching, he's taking his time, pitching a cautious game. A one-run lead, you know, doesn't mean an awful lot. He doesn't want it to get any bigger. Watches the bat. Man on first and third, two down, watch for the pitch. Here it comes. That's a lot. He swings at it from strike three. You're out. Two strikeouts for him this inning. Brings his strikeout record now up to five. Watson striking out of the ninth. So in the first half of the ninth inning, for the St. Louis Cardinals, we have no runs, two hits, there were no errors, and there were two men left in the base. Coming to bat on the last half of the ninth, we're going to see if these Tigers, who are famous for their last inning rallies, can do it again. That's what the crowd up here is yelling for. It's the hometown crowd for the Tigers. This inning tells the tale. If one run comes in, it's a tie. If more than one run comes in, it means that the Tigers have the World Series all to themselves. If no runs come in, it goes into a tie on games, and they have to play again tomorrow. The first man coming to bat should be Greenberg. He has struck out once, hauled out once to the shortstop, and has had one single, which drove in a run. Is the first man at bat. I beg your pardon. I have my summon, Greenberg, and calling him into the board. Owen comes to bat. He's tried out once to center, gone out twice to the infield. Owen coming to bat. In the last of the ninth, Cardine ready to pitch that ball down to him. Takes the first and wide and high. Ball one. Ball run to Owen. Dean has his next time from Delancey. The crowd started to cough it up. Owen takes a smack at it. Knocks a high foul over near first base. It looks like it might go into the crowd. It does. Into the second row of box seats in the upper tier. Making the call out. Ball run and strike one. Delancey throws the ball to Pepper Martin. Pepper throws the ball over to Duty Dean. So Paul Dean. Getting these dues mixed up again. Better to see what this next pitcher brings. Ball run and strike one to Owen. He takes a strike at it. So high run over toward first base. Collins is backing over in foul territory and takes the ball for the out. Owen out on a throw to Collins. That makes the first man out in the last half of the ninth and brings to bat Fox, the right fielder. Fox, the right fielder, is the ball coming to bat. When ball gets down to Fox, he looks it over carefully and calls it foul, right? Ball on the Fox. One man down, nobody on. 4-3 in favor of the Cardinals. Last of the night. Fox started for that one. Changed his mind and took it for the called strike. If he hits from the outside corner, a fast breaking serve. Ball one, strike one. Fox stands in close to the inside line of the plate. It is left foot well in toward the home plate. Watches the next pitch. Dean winds it up. Next one, calls for strike two. Hitting the inside corner. Just above the hip. Ball one and strike two. A fast ball. 1-2 to Fox. Fox turns around and throws something to the umpire. The umpire kicks the dirt away from the inside corner of the plate. Fox is waiting for it with a 1-2 count. Ball Dean has his time to allow to wind up start. Here's a pitch. There goes the far out toward left center. It's this way back deep. Orsatti is after it. Says he can take it, and he does. Fox out on a fly to Orsatti. Now he just comes up to bat. It should be Schoolboy Rowe, but in a case like this, with a score of 4-3 in favor of the St. Louis Cardinals, two men down in the last of the ninth, even though the Schoolboy has six nice balls, and it's a great favorite here, we'll in all probability see a new man come up here to bat for the Schoolboy. You're trying to pick him as he can bat? The Schoolboy is coming up to bat in his own position. Apparently, he's walking out there at least. Schoolboy is standing up there swinging a couple of bats. In the meantime, the infield of the Cardinals have gone into a huddle up on the mound. The entire infield is in there. Julian Martin, DeRocher, Fish, Cannon, Sapar, Dean, and Delancey. All in their batting. They start back toward their playing position. Now Dean takes a little advice from some of the older heads. There are two men down in the last of the ninth. If Paul Dean can get past this next hitter, he will have a chance to throw this World Series into another tie. Schoolboy Rowe steps into the batsman's box. Dean is sitting upon and gets ready to serve the first one up. Here it comes. Runs over the top of the catcher's head and hits against the backstop for a very wild throw. Long run. The catcher couldn't come close to it, and Rowe had to duck it. It was in close and high. The ball completely slipping out of the hands of Paul Dean. Ball out of the hitter.
Rowe's made down a sacrifice, struck out and tried out to center this afternoon. The next was a fast strike, ball. One run and strike one. It's Schoolboy Rowe, who turns around and says something to umpire Graham. Umpire Graham holds up one finger on each hand. Rowe watching for another one. Dean winds it up, fires one down there. Rowe hits it towards center field, way back deep. Orsatti goes back and yanks the ball down for the out. And a nice running catch deep in center field, way, way back deep. And we find the last half of the ninth inning for the Tigers. No runs, no hits, no errors, and no one left on bases. Which gives the Cardinals a total of 4 runs, 10 hits, 2 errors committed, and 6 men left on the bases. While the Tigers have 3 runs, 7 hits, 1 error, and 6 men left on the bases. That ends the ball game, and it throws it into a tie again. Each team having 3 games. We're going to have another ball game tomorrow from this same spot. Looks to me as if Ted Husing is ready to talk about what's been going on. I'll turn it over to Ted.
Thank you very much, Pat. The broadcast of this game has been sent to you by the Ford Motor Company, builders of Ford and Lincoln cars and Ford trucks. You are cordially invited to be their guests again tomorrow when the World Series battle is resumed here at Navin Field, Detroit. And in the meantime, watch the Fords go by. I'm going to turn the microphone back to Pat in just a second, because Pat has been keeping a summary of the game and its highlights. There's nothing much more to add from this side of the field, because Pat has all that information right at his fingertips and probably can look his score chart over to give you the highlight of the ninth inning. This, of course, is done for the late tuner inners who might have missed the game or who might just be able to get back to the radio listening post on time and on occasion. And here you are, Pat, for the summary.
Okay, Fred, I have it. Ladies and gentlemen, the most interesting thing about the game, the fact that there has been better fielding in this game than we have seen in any of the others, particularly in the outfield, of course, with the exception of that marvelous white catch yesterday by JoJo White. But I think the way the scoring was done might bring it back to you if you have not been able to listen to the entire game. In the first half of the first inning, Martin tried to Owen. Rothrock doubled to right. Frisch lined to Owen, who made a very nice catch. Rothrock was safe going back to second, although the throw was made over that point. Medrick came up and singled Rothrock in with the first run, and he went down to second himself on the throw to plate, making the score 1-0 in favor of the Cardinals. The next scoring came in the last half of the third when Detroit came to bat. White walked and went down to second when Frisch dropped Delancey's throw as he attempted to steal. He got up and continued to third when nobody picked the ball up, and it was given as an error on the second baseman. Cochran singled to the infield, and White scored, tying the thing at 1-1. Then Geringer flied to Rothrock. There was no more scoring until the first half of the fifth, when the Guards came to bat, and DeRocher singled to Geringer. He hit the ball off his glove, but he made a single, back to second. A nice stop by Mr. Geringer, but nothing was done about it, no throw at first. Paul Dean sacrificed to Greenberg. Martin singled and scored DeRocher, and then he continued on to second on the throw to the plate, and went over to third on Gosman's error when he made a wide throw to the plate, making his score there 2-1 at that point. Rothrock went out from Rogel to Greenberg. Martin came and scored in the infield out, putting the Cards ahead 3-1. And then Frisch to end that half of the inning, fouled off to Cochran. The next scoring was in the last half of the sixth inning. At that time, the Tigers came to bat, and White walked again. Cochran singled, and White went to third on the first pitch. The tying runs were then on base. Geringer was safe on Dean's error on a slow roller that he left low between his feet. White came in and scored, and Geringer went to first base, Cochran moving to second, making the score 3-2. Then Gosman popped a bunt to the catcher, who got Cochran at third base on a throw over from Delancey to Martin. Geringer moved to second in the infield out. Gosman went to first and was safe on a fielder's choice. Rogel flied to Orsatti. Geringer moved over to third after that deep fly into center. Greenberg came up and singled to left, scoring Geringer and bringing the point up to 3-3 tie. Gosman went to second. Greenberg was on first. Owen went out from DeRocher over to Collins. In the seventh inning, the score that really went the ball game for the St. Louis Cardinals was brought in this way. Orsatti came up and flied to Gosman. DeRocher smacked a double out toward right center. Then Paul Dean, the pitcher, actually won his own ball game by singling and scoring DeRocher, making the score 4-3, which is the final. Martin flied to Fox, and Rothrock went out from Owen to Greenberg. Those were all the scoring chances, ladies and gentlemen, during the game. The final score
four runs, 10 hits, 2 errors, and 6 left-hand bases for the St. Louis Cardinals. For the Tigers, 3 runs, 7 hits, 1 error, and 6 left-hand bases. We have Rowe giving 10 hits, 4 runs, striking out 5. His opponent, Paul Dean, gave 7 hits, 3 runs, struck out 4, and walked 2. I believe it's time to turn the microphone back to Ted Husing, who will give you some of the highlights of this game, and then we'll see you again tomorrow. Bye.
Thank you very much, Pat. There's just one highlight that I want to give, and that is that records are going into the book. And when I say into the book, I mean Charlie White's Little Red Book, which is the official book that is used by all the press representatives for checking the best records in the major leagues. It's probably the only publication containing the authentic figures of every department of professional baseball, and it's the one that we're quoting every so now and then. In order to give you some idea how quickly those records come up, you'll remember that a new record was set today in center field by outfielder Rossotti in the fifth, when he retired the entire side, catching 3 of the flies that were popped out into that portion of the ball arches. White tied the record for 6 games with 8 walks, a record previously held by Dave Ruth. Of course, as you know, Frisch cracks 4 records almost every time he steps to bat. He's now been at bat 192 times in total series play. That is a total of 8 series, and the series isn't over yet. He's been at the World Series, 8 series, but 49 games. And, of course, playing tomorrow, barring any accident, he will make his 50th game and be way out in front for a number of games played. He has 57 hits in total series, and 45 of them are singles. There are many other records that we could give you, but as they come up, we'll pass them on to Frank Lutz or Pat Flanagan, whichever of the two men happen to be broadcasting. Tomorrow is the concluding day. It's 3-3 and another game at Navin Field, Detroit. Now, don't forget, weather permitting, the Ford Motor Company brings you another World Series game tomorrow at exactly 1:15 Eastern Standard Time. Your announcer, Ted Husing, having followed in the wake of Frank Lutz and Pat Flanagan, did you a blast. This is the Columbia Broadcasting System.